This commissioning video shows how to configure a Civics card working as a Profinet I/O controller to communicate with the Hilscher Netfield I/O Link Gateway using Cycon.net. In this example, an I/O Link display from IFM E30391 is connected to port 2 of the Netfield Gateway. To start with the configuration, please first of all select the I/O controller from the list of available devices. In this case, please select the Civics card and add it to the gray bus line via drag and drop. To add the Netfield I/O device to the Profinet network, which is shown as a green line in Cycon.net, first of all add it to the Cycon.net device catalog by importing the device description file. Therefore, select Network, Import Device Description. Check for the correct data type to be selected and select the Netfield GSDML file. Accept the upcoming window to reload the device catalog. Now add the Netfield I/O device via drag and drop from the list of available slaves. The added slave represents the I/O device with which the I/O controller will communicate later on. Therefore, the configuration needs to fit the current structure of the I/O device. Right-click to the device and select Configuration to change the current default configuration delivered by the GSDML file. Select the module configuration and add a new module. Since this is an 8-port IO-Link Master Gateway, select the fitting module. Open the subslot configurations and change the port where the IFM IO-Link display is located. In this case, subslot 2 needs to be selected. The IFM display is already available in the GSDML file. That's all that needs to be done in the IO device configuration. Now change to the I/O controller configuration. Define the Civics card which needs to be configured by using the device assignment. If you're using a Civics 90, please choose All in the device selection. Apply your changes. In the navigation area, choose Firmware and download the firmware for use as in Profinet I/O controller. Wait until the download has finished. In the controller network settings, define a fixed IP address for the I/O controller. Open the device table to define the name of station of the connected I/O device. In Profinet, the I/O controller identifies the I/O devices by its name of station. In this case, the name of station of the Netfield I/O device will be defined later. Therefore, a desired name can be chosen. In this case, we will use the default name. In the IP address table of the I/O controller, the IP address which will be set by the I/O controller to a device concerning its name of station is defined. Now define an automatic start of the communication in the controller settings. Accept and close your configurations. Download the configuration to the device. Accept that all communications will be stopped during download process. SciCon.net will now automatically connect to the Civics card and therefore make diagnosis available. Open the diagnosis to see the current state of communication. As we can see, there's currently no communication established. The station diagnosis indicates that there has been no response to the DCP ident request of the I/O controller. Since the name of station for the Netfield I/O device has not been set yet, this is an expected behavior. To set the name of station to the Netfield I/O device, a DCP tool is needed. For that, the Ethernet device setup, which is installed together with SciCon.net, can be used. Connect your Profinet network with the network card on your PC and scan for devices. As you can see, the Netfield I/O device is now shown in the table of available devices. Define the needed name of station or device name to the Netfield device. This needs to be completely equal to the name defined in the I/O controller settings. With another scan, you can see that the IP address will now automatically be set by the I/O controller. Open the Civics diagnosis again, where you can see a fully working communication now. To check whether cyclic process data can be transferred, open the I/O monitor. The IFN display shows different values when pressing any button. This is visible here in the data input area. Also, output data can be sent without any issue. Please visit our support space, support.hilscher.com, to find more commissioning examples, application notes, and more helpful stuff. Thank you for watching.